Imagine you're a sheep rancher just going about your business. While it's hard work, you happily tend to your thousands of sheep. It's how you make a living, and you rely on them in the same way that they rely on you for food and water. For ranchers living in School Valley, Utah, which, by the way, is an incredibly ominous name, that's how much of their lives were. There were the ups and downs of ranching, like droughts or unusually rainy years, but nothing completely unexpected. On March 14, 1968, the ranchers of Skull Valley saw something that they would never forget. One rancher called the county sheriff, Faye Gillette, who soon after arrived on the scene. In front of Gillette lay thousands of sheep, either sick, paralyzed, or dead. What could have happened? To understand what happened in Skull Valley, you have to rewind another 50 years before what would soon be called the Dugway Sheep Incident, named after a U.S. Army facility, happened. In 1915, World War I was raging in Europe. The Germans, looking for an edge over the Allied forces, began releasing chlorine gas. As the gas drifted over the Allied trenches, they hastily retreated as they were faced with an unfamiliar threat. However, the German soldiers themselves were wary of the gas. Indeed, significant exposure to chlorine gas can lead to both irritation and asphyxiation. Angry at such agonizing methods of war, the British quickly developed their own chemical weapons program, so basically doing the same thing. In place of chlorine, phosgene was soon used as it was much deadlier, accounting for 85% of the chemical weapons-related deaths in World War I. Soon after, France and the US developed their own fledgling chemical weapons programs. Mustard gas entered the scene in 1917, and the agonizing, blistering, and bleeding of victims scarred those that saw its destructive potential. After World War I, the public turned against the idea of chemical weapons due to their brutal nature. Predictably, that did not stop countries from refining and, in some cases, creating more potent forms of chemical weapons. The US in particular began producing and stockpiling a synthetic chemical weapon named Venomous Agent X, or VX for short, after its discovery in the 1950s. VX is an odorless and tasteless chemical which is so deadly that less than 10 milligrams of it is enough to kill a human by asphyxiation via paralysis of the respiratory muscles. To test such chemicals, the US needed a remote testing facility. In 1942, they opened the Dugway Proving Ground, about 85 miles southwest of Salt Lake City, Utah. At the Proving Ground, the Army tested everything chemical, including toxic agents, flamethrowers, chemical spray systems, biological warfare weapons, firebombing tactics, and more. As is the case with most military testing, the Proving Ground was highly secretive and few outsiders knew the extent of the facility's work. Fast forward to that gruesome day in 1968, and Sheriff Gillette couldn't figure out what happened. Did all the sheep eat a poisonous plant? Was it some sort of pesticide? Was something in the water? Or, as the public soon started to suspect, was it the US Army's largest base for chemical and biological weapons testing, located only 27 miles away from the sheep? Initially, the Dugway Proving Ground denied any involvement, but as more sheep succumbed to their strange illness, the facility couldn't contain the secret. 7 days after the initial sheep deaths, Senator Frank Moss of Utah released a Pentagon document that stated that a high-speed jet had sprayed 320 gallons of nerve gas VX across the Dugway grounds in a weapons test a day before the gruesome scene began. In the weeks and months that followed, scientists discovered that the jet that sprayed the VX gas had malfunctioned. The malfunction meant that its delivery tanks accidentally released the gas at a much higher altitude than intended, allowing it to be blown far from the testing grounds. The sheep had unknowingly been grazing on grass covered in the chemical. By December, a study conducted by the American Association for the Advancement of Science discovered that the water, soil, and sheep blood all contained traces of the VX gas. The evidence was damning. Despite the widespread coverage of the Dugway sheep incident, not much changed in the immediate aftermath. Some people pointed to the military being Utah's largest employer as a reason not to ruffle any feathers, or wool, I guess. As for the sheep, the Army never released an official report. They did, however, pay about $376,000 to a rancher named Alvin Hatch, whose sheep made up 90% of those affected or killed. They also so kindly lent some bulldozers for the ranchers to bury their sheep. For a short period, that was that. It made the news, but it didn't make big waves. That was until Senator Richard McCarthy, not the McCarthyism and Red Scare guy, saw a documentary about the incident in February of 1969, a year after the incident. Up until that point, the American public was never aware of the chemical stockpiles sprinkled across the U.S. Between 1961 and 1969, the military dumped hundreds of thousands of tons of chemical weapons into the ocean while also having leaky stockpiles. Senator McCarthy began a series of congressional hearings that uncovered the extent of the U.S. chemical weapons program. He also brought to light a disposal process that the military used called CHASE, cut holes and sink 'em. After a handful of other incidents, the American public slowly began realizing the extent of the American chemical weapons program, and this resulted in the federal government stopping the military from using them. But they could still use them domestically against protests, but whatever, that's not important. By 1997, nearly every country in the world had ratified the Chemical Weapons Convention, which prohibited the production, stockpiling, and deployment of chemical weapons. It also required the destruction of those weapons. It took the U.S. another 26 years, but they finally destroyed the last of their chemical weapons on July 7th, 2023. With that, the world became officially free of chemical weapons. Obviously, there are still chemical weapons out there. There are remaining stockpiles from non-compliant states, and rogue forces have been able to use them on occasion. The most famous recent example is Syrian leader Bashar al-Assad using toxins against Syrian opposition forces. Either way, 99% of all chemical weapons ever created no longer exist. For the US, that reality would not have happened without a bunch of sheep grazing at the wrong place and the wrong time.